In this video, I'm going to answer one of the most commonly asked questions from people working with power apps, which is model-driven apps or canvas apps. How do I choose? Which one should I use? And I've got one simple test for you to be able to figure that out. Let me level set to start with on what these two things are. So a canvas app is called a canvas app because it's a blank canvas. When you open it up, you can put whatever you like, wherever you like on the screen. And most importantly, you choose your data source. What do I want to connect this to? Blank canvas, connect to any data source. A model-driven app is called that because it starts with a data model. What kinds of data do I have? How do I want them to relate to each other? And then a user interface goes over that. A model-driven app is built on Microsoft Dataverse, which is the database platform that sits underneath the whole of Power Platform. So here's my test question for you so that you can figure this out. You're coming to Power Apps to build an app of some kind. Do you already have a data source that you are happy with that is serving you well? That's my question. Now, if that means you're coming along and you're like, yeah, I've got a CRM system and everything's in there and I'm happy with that and I want to build an app on top of that so that I can make it easier for my salespeople to work with their opportunities, that's a canvas app on top of that data source. If you say, I've got a SharePoint list, 300 records, that's working well for me, but I want an app to make it easier to not have to fill that out on a paper-based form on the run because we're duplicating data entry, also canvas app. If you're like, no, I need an app and I've got data on a spreadsheet here and a spreadsheet there and it's all over the place. You don't have a data source that you're happy with. Or, yeah, I'm working on Microsoft Access and that's a legacy system and that we isn't working out for us. So if you don't have a data source at all, or you don't have a data source that you are happy with that is serving you well, that is your candidate right there for a model-driven app. So model-driven app is about starting with that data model, and it must be on Microsoft Dataverse. You can't have a model-driven app connected to anything else because that's canvas app. So what it allows you to do is quickly and easily structure your data. Check out my tutorial on how you do that if you'd like to know more. You can model up your security, all of the access and permissions and everything, all with no code. So this is meant to be a really accessible starting point for using a really, really powerful data source without having to be an expert in putting together databases and coding around those kinds of things. And then you design the user interface over the top of it. Now, the huge benefit, if you do end up in a situation of putting your data in Microsoft Dataverse and a model-driven app, is that you have now got the full benefit of all sorts of things that fire off on the platform. AI insights, growing this thing to a scale beyond which you can probably imagine right now. So that's pretty much it. Canvas app, blank canvas, connect to any data source. Model-driven app is what you use when you don't have a data source that you're happy with and you need to build an application. It's going to organize your data and give you a lovely user interface on top of it. Also, doesn't have to be an either or. You can totally connect a canvas app to that one or embed a canvas app in that one. I hope that's been helpful and clarifying the difference between those things. Thanks for watching.